Getting to your destination on time is about to get easier for bus riders. At least that's what one local company is hoping. We first told you last month about a pilot plan to install digital signs showing bus arrival times. The signs were installed today. If it's successful, the city will consider making them permanent. So how good are they at tracking the buses, and will fares go up to pay for them? We sent Bridget Namata to get answers. Bridget?
Joe, we are on the corner of Hotel and Richard Street at a bus stop. A new digital sign was installed this morning. It's installed right on top of the actual existing bus stop sign. So far, it's been pretty accurate. We've been watching it, and it is in line, in sync with the buses, and it is helpful as long as people know it's there. 8 digital signs were installed at bus stops downtown and in the Kalihi area. They're new, they're blue, and they're on top of existing bus route signs, counting down arrival times.
To have something like that, I think it's the best thing.
I think it'll make what is necessary much more enjoyable. People that take the bus, we should make it as enjoyable as we can for them, which involves peace of mind.
Sign maker Waysign hopes the signs will encourage more users to ride the bus. They believe it will help create less traffic on the roads.
How accurate are these signs?
So every single bus has a GPS locationing system installed, and it's as accurate as that GPS. So we actually collect all that data. The bus formats it in a way where we can grab it and then display it for our users.
Bus riders weren't happy when I told them the signs will only be around for 6 months.
It's not permanent?
No, it's just a project right now.
Well, it should be permanent. It should be permanent.
So I checked with Oahu Transit Services to see whether they'll consider keeping the signs around. The answer is yes, as long as the signs are successful and if they can budget for them. But will riders see a fare increase?
Whether it's a $500,000 project or $1 million project, you would not see increased fares for this type of communication system.
12 more digital signs will be installed tomorrow. There is a number on the sign. The city needs feedback to see whether riders find the signs helpful. That number will be on our website, khon2.com. Live downtown, Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.